Hey guys, and thank you so much for tuning into a brand new episode of Good Children. Don't forget to subscribe to our Patreon.
It is $7 a month. You're getting one extra episode per week every single Friday.
Video and audio.
Video and audio. And let me tell you something.
Some people are saying we give too much. Some people are saying we're doing too much with Patreon. We should scale back. That. We're giving too much to them.
I've been hearing that because when you think about it, we've said this before, but it's less than $2 an episode.
And I think, why not? You know, I live to give. Well, and I live to give to our beautiful, sexy patrons.
We're thinking about innovating on the Patreon as well. But let me just tell you something. It's kind of been taking off.
It's taking off. The patrons are here. And I'll say, like, there's a chance that price goes up soon. I'm not saying no one who's already subscribed will get that price increase. But if you want to get in on the early, do you know what I mean?
Not you. Lock in the lower price.
I'm saying you kind of have to lock in the lower price because maybe it's going to go up soon. And then what? I don't want someone to have to suffer the consequences of waiting to join Patreon.
I completely agree.
Because we both know it's going places that we can't even imagine.
We can't. I get so scared thinking about the fact that, like, it's going to be whole out so soon.
The digital footprint we're creating is ruining our lives.
Oh, for sure.
Do you think that because you're back on anxiety meds, we're not going to be funny again?
What do you mean? I honestly think that, like, I'm just going to be a little bit, like, calmer and, like, about, like, being in my head.
But, like, when you think about the fact that, like, the podcast took a downturn, honestly, when you got on meds, and then took an upturn when you stopped taking the meds.
Wait.
I'm not saying correlation equals causation.
But it's kind of spooky.
You know what I mean?
I started popping two pills a day and
the
people started
saying. The moment
Bussy Pone
dropped is the moment that people were like, I'm done with this shit. And then you stopped taking it and people are like, we love them again.
They're like, wait, they're really funny. They're fun.
You know what I mean?
Yeah. Wow. Maybe it is just like deep diving into anxiety instead of medicating yourself.
It kind of makes you think.
Good children.
I think taking risks is a part of life, and I think I just took a risk.
I think you took a risk, and yeah, it paid off.
Do you think so?
I do. I think that, like, what you just showed was your inevitable talent.
You're right.
Yeah.
Hey guys, and welcome back to Good Children, the podcast where hosts Joe Hegyes
and Andrew Muscarella
reflect on our 22 years of friendship.
Growing up in the late 2000s, early 2010s.
And all of the nostalgia,
drama,
and cults that come along with it. What are we talking about today?
Today we're talking wholesale.
Oh my God. Oh my God. I was like, are we? Like, I wouldn't say no.
I would say no.
Surprise.
Yeah. Yeah. No. Today
I love
wholesale. Wholesale stores.
Yeah.
You know them. You love them.
And
or not.
Okay. So fuck, marry, kill. BJ's, Sam's Club, or Costco.
Oh, this is tough.
I know.
I honestly think I'm gonna fuck Costco.
Okay.
I'm gonna marry BJ. BJ's, and I'm gonna kill Sam's Club.
You're missing out on Sam's Club, though. You don't get it.
Yeah,
you don't get it.
I haven't experienced Sam's
Club. I think if you went into a Sam's Club, your life would change. I would say I'm marrying BJ's, I'm fucking Sam's Club, and I'm
killing Costco. Remember.
I was actually a BJ's head.
And that isn't that funny. I just think, okay, I do want to think about this for a second.
Please.
Because BJ's, one thing about me, we always know, always thinking.
You're thinking.
They're all competing against each other. It's kind of like.
Do you think on the low they're like friends, like Sam, BJ, and Costco?
Okay, let's discuss.
When one of them wins, they all win.
Yeah, but I think that Costco doesn't think that their shit stinks.
BJ's and Costco, like, they really do make me think of summer. I almost see BJ's as more idyllic summer than, like, a pool or a beach.
Really?
I'd rather have gone, if given the opportunity at 10 years old to go to the beach or BJ's in the summer, I would have chosen BJ's 10 times out of 10.
Yeah, because there's air conditioning and samples.
With that being said, I love all of these queens at the top of their game equally. But if I had to pick, that's what I would pick.
The only reason I'm in disbelief is just because I feel like Costco, there's been so many fond memories at Costco.
It's been BJ's. When we were going, when me and you were like up, it's 8 a.m. It's the summer. You're over my house already somehow. We're going to BJ's. We weren't going to Costco. Costco,
see, like that.
It was always a BJ's household.
I was just a Costco household.
Yeah, no.
Some of us are raised different.
Yeah. Some of us are raised right. Right. The openness and availability of a wholesale big box store is the freedom it brings.
There's
a
so burgeoning much
gay youth.
Yes. There is so much space to roam. There's also, like, again, your parents have what they want in mind.
Yes.
They don't want you to take that away from them. No. They say,
go do whatever you want.
Go do whatever you want. Maybe there are samples. Go get some. Go get
a sample.
Go get some.
Go look at the toys.
Because,
go look at
the books. Well, they know, first of all, once you get into one of these spaces, one of these wholesale stores, you just fought for your life.
Just to get into the door.
Just to get a parking spot.
Oh, yeah.
Can you, these freaking parking lots, like, you're parking miles away.
No, America has a problem.
America
It's so bad. Parking lots in general should be abolished. Like, we need to move past the need for cars and parking lots.
I was going to say, Joe, where are the cars going to go?
Get rid of the cars. I don't have a car. I'm doing just fine.
Well, how are people going to get around?
Public transport and walking. Walkable cities. Enough with this shit. I shouldn't have to drive 30 minutes to Sam's Club.
But what if you live in a suburb?
Make all suburbs walkable. Make all suburbs walkable.
What if it's a big suburb?
Why are you literally a fascist? Like, why can't we just have walkable cities?
Listen, I think that walkable
cities
sounds
absolutely gorgeous and beautiful. You're the only bitch on this planet who's anti-walkable city.
And beautiful. I love to walk. Don't get me wrong. I'm thinking logically saying, how are you going to get to these places?
Do you know who thought logically?
Who?
No one you could name, because anyone who thought logically didn't make a difference on this planet. You have to think illogically.
That's not true. I think that a car is needed, or maybe a bicycle.
Out of the box. Out of the box. Yeah, a bicycle. Sure, that's different than a car. Sure, take a bicycle. Take a damn bus. Take a bus. But don't take a car.
I'll take a bus. But then what if it drops me a mile away from Costco?
Well, why would it? It shouldn't.
Andrew, we're gonna have
get
to
into
talk.
Local politics. Elect legislators. Change the world. Change the planet.
You want me to get into local politics? I'll
if
do
you
this.
You want to. I know you want to.
Am I the Pete Buttigieg of local politics?
No, you're the George Santos.
That's so fucked up. Pete Buttigieg is in charge of transportation.
You know a lot about the government. Pete Buttigieg. Do you think he's ever had sex?
No.
Okay.
I think that Pete Buttigieg, like, is someone who will, like, suck.
Andrew, I'm not putting this in the podcast.
I was going to say, and won't kiss after.
But Chasten, they seem so happy.
Yeah, maybe they are sweet and they're so happy.
You're actually so Chasten Buttigieg coded, because you would change your last name for your husband.
I would actually
love
that.
Are we saying his
life.
Name right?
Pete Buttigieg?
Pete Buttigieg? Sound right. Buttigieg?
Buttigieg.
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 That's honestly. But anyways, you're in the parking lot. You get in.
Right.
It is.
So you get one of the biggest carts.
Oh, yeah.
Like the size of a shopping cart in like a Costco. It's the size of a boat.
Yes. Oh, absolutely. I mean, like.
You could just take the boat, the cart.
You're trying to swing that cart around the freaking aisles.
And don't get me started on when a cart is faulty, but it's too late because you've already accepted your fate. When you start walking and then 3 minutes later,
one wheel doesn't work. Yeah, it's either squeaking or, again, one wheel for some reason
gives out on you.
Can no longer turn.
It retires.
And it's just, yeah, I mean,
you have to lift the whole cart up on one side to turn. That was what gave me driving anxiety.
Well, that's probably why you don't have a license.
That's why I'm anti-car.
Yeah, that's why you're screaming.
Carts and BJs.
But to get into the BJs, the fact that, like, Did you ever get nervous? I guess I was with my parents, but sometimes my parents would give me the card and be like, run in.
Because it felt like a police state.
And because they have to check your card. So what you would do is you just flash the card. A lot of the times, they want to see the back.
Yeah.
Some of the cards have pictures.
Yeah.
I'm not my mother.
And like for some reason, as a kid, you do think that like everyone's out to get you. Yes. Like you're like, they're going to be so, like as if. As if the 19-year-old working at Costco who doesn't give a fuck sees a 9-year-old and thinks you shouldn't be here. Or they're like, yeah, your mom is like waiting for you. That was the worst, the worst feeling though. I'm like, no, I'm going to get in trouble. Or like also even walking in, like the way that I would cling to my mom to make sure that the card checker knew I was with her.
Yeah, it's like with them.
I'm like, I'm not alone. Them. I'm not alone. I'm not an unaccompanied minor at Costco. Then you walk in and there's priorities.
There, I mean, you walk in and you're smacked in the face with the TVs.
Yeah.
But also, you might not have ever experienced this, but the optometrist.
Did you go to, you went to the optometrist at Costco?
Yeah.
Is that where your eyes were getting checked?
Yeah, my eyes were getting checked
at Costco. No wonder the holes. No wonder the retinal holes.
Well, listen, there's only so far that the Costco employee can go because they couldn't catch the holes. I had to go to Davis Vision for that. But that's beside the point. Costco, though, can do a quick check. But I was getting my contacts cheap. So I'm
sure,
cheap.
I'm sure.
And they're readily available.
You got them day of?
Day of. I go in there and say, hey, can I get 3 boxes of -4.75 or -5?
And they just had
they
it?
Said, yeah, let me go get them. And they get them. 3 boxes right there in front of your face.
I'm sorry. You can't beat.
You can't beat that.
You can't beat it. Like, the Costco free sample workers are working on the front lines to make sure that every single child is fed while they are shopping with their mom in Costco in the summer.
And the fact that their role is Costco sampler, I feel like for that hour, I can't imagine that hour, especially
it's the
when
role
they
of
give
a
you,
lifetime.
When they say, Peggy,
you got
today,
the meatballs?
You got the oven.
Yeah.
Stu, today you got the crock pot. Can you imagine?
And you are just circling that crock pot like a fucking shark.
Yep. I'm actually almost straining my neck to see how much more time is on that timer.
They'd be like, oh, come back in 6 minutes.
And I'm like,
I'll be there.
6 minutes?
I'll be there.
But you know what's the worst when you're at Costco? When you're a little bit below the age and you go up to them and they say, where's your mom?
What?
Yes, you never got allergy alerted. They said, you have any peanut allergies? And I'd be like, no. They were like, well, I need your mother to confirm.
Andrew, they were profiling you.
They looked, they took one look at me. They said, please get away from the fucking egg rolls. Get away from me and the egg rolls. Yeah.
Wait.
I would have to find my mom. And listen, that didn't stop me. I would find my mom in the store. I would tell her to come with me. And she would say, he's all good. And I would get the sample.
The thing about finding your mom at a Costco is it is close to the hardest thing you could ever have to do in your life. It is so cavernous and scary.
Yes.
Going down those aisles being like, where the hell is she? And then I always used to be like, I don't want people to know that I'm missing. I don't want people. I don't want anyone else to know that right now I'm a missing child.
Yes.
Like, God forbid an employee is like, do you need help? Or and can you find, like, and I'm like, I can't find my mom and I'm 7. Like, I like, this is up to me.
Yeah.
This is my job. I will search the electronic section. I will search the back area. I will go to the meats. I will find her. And I don't need any help.
No, it is really, really scary.
It's scary.
But when in doubt, just stand at the front. Just stand at the front. Right by the snacks, by the gummies, by the anything. She'll find her way.
No, I would search the whole store 7 times.
But then don't you experience panic?
The whole time. I'm never not experiencing panic in my life, especially as a child. There was not one moment, no matter where I was not panicking.
Holy crap.
Especially in a Costco. Especially in a Costco.
Especially in a Costco. But you knew you were getting that damn ice cream afterwards or the churro stick.
Oh, my God. God.
Stop. I can't. I can literally
just. The Costco
just...
line was so long, and you got to say to your mom, can you give me $5 so I can just go to the cafe and wait for you? And you're like, I'm getting a personal pizza for $3.45. Like... The prices in Costco were like the 1950s.
Yes, they always
for just
have been.
The cafe.
They always have been when it came to the cafe.
They were selling you it for cheap. It was hot and cheap.
99 cent foot hot dogs. You can't get that anywhere. The thing about BJ's is. They have a deal with fracking because what? They have they have gas stations.
Oh my God, the BJ's gas stations.
Yeah.
That would almost be a trip in and of itself. Yeah. Because you were getting discounted gas, right? Yeah,
which is like how is that happening?
How is that happening?
Who are you contacting that you can get discounted gas in this
I remember
state?
During Hurricane Sandy, BJ's was like one of the only operational gas stations left at one point.
It's like,
and there was like lines to the 110 to get to the
RuPaul
BJ's.
RuPaul has a hand in this.
RuPaul owns BJ's.
I think, yeah. So Walmart owns Sam's Club. RuPaul owns BJ's. And Costco doesn't need an owner.
Up for grabs. I do think that Sam's Club honestly has the widest variety
of just
everything. And it is so, that's the other thing about like a wholesale store is like they're so big. The amount of land it takes to run a BJ's is the same amount of land that some countries possess.
Can you imagine being the store manager?
No, because you might as well be president of the United States.
Yeah, I mean,
it's actually genuinely, it's when you walk in, you're like, am I in an airport? Mm-hmm. Am I in a hangar right now?
And you have never seen ceilings that
so
high.
So unfinished. That's something about something warm to me about an unfinished ceiling in a big box store.
Yes.
I think that Sam's Club, though, really is like, I don't remember much. I went during COVID. And I remember it just being so, so huge.
Yeah.
Like absurdly large. I would love to go back.
I would love to come with you to a Sam's Club. And listen, all of these major wholesale stores have some of the top tier bakeries, I would say, in the country.
The smell of a BJ's bakery.
Because I don't care what your local bakery, I don't care what cookie they're turning.
No, I'm sorry, small
businesses. It's not better than the chocolate jug.
The smell, the intoxicating siren smell of a bakery in a Costco.
It's like, who you needs to go? And they might go there, but I don't think you need to go to a Parisian bakery
school. You don't have to go to Paris.
You don't have to go to Paris. If you want a croissant, go to Costco. Some people are going to say, oh, they don't know a good croissant. No, I do.
You don't know Costco.
And they're probably bigger than the croissant that you know.
Well, I remember actually in sixth grade going to getting their croissants when I was in French class. Because remember sixth grade, you got the sampler platter. You did French, Spanish, Italian, and ASL. I wish I did ASL, first of all. If I could go back in time and do one thing differently, I would sign up for ASL for everything. Because this is not going to cut it. You know what I mean? Like, that's not enough.
The alphabet is not going to cut it. No. My name is also not cutting it.
I wouldn't be able to even do that. How long did you learn ASL?
Yeah, Joe.
Did we do it like after? Remember going to ASL in like elementary school?
Elementary school, yeah. It was the same.
That makes sense. Yeah,
Mrs. Nymphus.
Fifth grade. And I was like, I'm gonna be able to speak fluent ASL by seventh grade.
Again, I don't even want to think about the fact that this education system is so messed up.
It's
that
so
we're not
crazy.
All learning American Sign Language. Like, what the hell?
It is actually insane.
I mean, cuts. Don't even.
Why did this get brought up? Oh, I'll never forget. Like, there are some things I'll never forget. And one of them is I got a 60-pack bag of croissants from BJ's to bring into my French class for, like, whatever, like, bring in a French food day and get five extra points on your
I got the Madeline assignment. Cookies from Starbucks.
From Starbucks?
Yeah, they got Madeline's.
In sixth grade?
Yeah.
Your dad was, like, an early adopter of Starbucks.
Yeah.
How many cookies did you bring in?
I think there was like 20, and it's a 2-pack, so I probably had about 10 packs of those.
That's crazy.
Probably a waste of money. My dad probably racked up points.
He tells people he
speaks Starbuckian, so.
That's pretty crazy.
Yeah.
He had to really just have a lot of money for that.
Of course.
I really think I was almost going to tie it back for a second. What was I going
to
say?
Were you going to say something about the 60-pack of croissants? Because did your French teacher happen to say anything about the Costco croissants?
As in, like, this is a problem?
Or were they good? Were they judging you?
I don't think they judged me. I think everyone was happy to have a croissant.
Of course.
It was almost my first croissant I remember eating. It was in sixth grade in my French class from Costco, if I'm being honest. Why are teachers allowed to assign extra credit that is bring in a treat? and you get 5 extra points on your GPA.
If I was a teacher, no, yeah, that's all I'd do.
I would, the whole class would be centered around bringing in a little treat. But what the hell? I remember getting extra credit for the Costco croissant.
Yes, of course. And it was like, what's interesting here is that you have to spend $30 to get 5 points.
Right.
Interesting.
For some of us, they spent $45 on Madeline cookies.
Yeah, some of us did. Sixth grade, we don't have to get back into sixth grade, but sixth grade, they were turning out bonus extra credit points and, by the fives.
Yes. Any chance you could get.
Any chance they could get, they would throw shit out.
They were like, go ahead, do a little fucking video about the Mesozoic era.
They're like, do on it. Learn the Greek alphabet, and you'll get 5 points on your exam. Anything. They'll do anything. And I lived for it.
I lived for a bonus question. It was always so fun when the bonus question would be fun.
Oh,
you know, when it wasn't.
When it wasn't like.
It was like, whose song is Bye Bye Bye? And you'd be like.
I'm my fucking luck. I put Backstreet Boys and I wouldn't get
over.
It.
It'd be over.
And I'd be so.
You'd be crying. That's a moment where you'd be crying.
Joe. Yes.
Obviously. Like, it's just not fair because I knew it was in sync.
Because what would happen is I would end that exam and I'd be like. I crushed it.
I got 105.
And you're talking about, like, wasn't it so fun that they asked, like, who sang Bye Bye Bye? That's so easy, right?
It's you insane. Would start crying.
I would cry.
I see it so vividly.
I would cry on spot. On spot.
On spot. Yeah. And you would make it everyone else's problem.
Yeah, absolutely.
Yeah, because I'd be like, no, Andrew, it wasn't Backstreet Boys. It was insane.
And then I start crying. Right? This is how I do it. I start crying now. Maybe not you. The person who told me feels bad.
Right. Yeah. No. Yes. Now I would feel bad.
Yeah. Of course.
And now it's everyone's. And then the teacher says, "Andrew, why are you crying?" And then you're like,
"And then I'm crying even more."
Answer on this thing.
It's like, stop being such a baby. And then
you get the 5 points.
Then that's trauma. And then now I have a podcast and I'll talk about that.
I think that you'd end up getting the bonus point.
I would at least get 3 extra. They did that sometimes. They'd be like, "You wouldn't get the full 5. I'd get 3." I miss when we were talking about Costco.
Kirkland socks. I know you know them. I know you're not familiar with a sock pretty often, but I know you know Kirkland socks.
I know a thing or two about Kirkland socks.
Kirkland's best.
Well, I'll tell you something about Kirkland socks. I don't love that they're not as tight at the top as they should be.
They slip?
They're a slippy sock. Slipping
and sliding but socks.
I love one with an elastic band at the top because
to keep your curves locked in on the ankle.
Yes. Mm-hmm. To when I'm a little bit high in sodium and my legs are swelling,
yeah,
for there to be a little indent. I want to see the indent.
That always makes me sick.
Because it's like, am I just not drinking enough water?
I think I'm not kidding. Like, I think I have scarring on my like waistband from like clothes being like jeans being too tight on me in middle school. Like, I'm not even kidding.
What do you
like? Mean? I really, it's either, I mean, it's, I'm sure it's also stretch marks, but like, I really think I was wearing jeans so tight every single day.
You came into school barely being able to breathe.
Yeah, I haven't breathed since.
I mean, no wonder you have anxiety.
No wonder I had anxiety. Had. I'm using it in past tense now.
Yeah, that's because you've graduated therapy.
So I graduated therapy.
Yeah, you don't have anxiety anymore.
No.
Wow. Maybe if I had tight pants in middle school, I wouldn't be popping pills.
I think you still would be.
Hmm.
How do they get so many rotisserie chickens?
I don't want... I feel like there has to be a Netflix documentary about Costco chickens, but...
In general, the plight of the chicken really terrifies me because it
freaks me out.
We could access on any given day if we devoted our whole day to counting chickens in stores easily in just Bushwick. 1 million chickens, right?
Joe, I think, well...
Between supermarkets, regular markets, butchers, Inca KFC, chicken shops, everything, you'd be able to get to 1 million chickens a day being output in just North Brooklyn. Where are all the chickens? How big are the slaughterhouses? How many slaughterhouses are there? How many chicken are in each slaughterhouse? Where are the farms that are raising these chickens? How many eggs are produced a day? Think about the eggs, Andrew. Think about the eggs.
There's so many eggs. Still, there was a shortage.
And yet.
And this is why I'm going to become a vegetarian.
Because of the avian flu?
Because of chickens.
Well, it's kind of crazy to think about how what those chickens must go through.
And they can't move.
They can't move. And they remember so faces. They're so big. They remember. They have incredible memories, chickens.
They remember
faces. But they
faces.
Taste so good.
Oh, no. They remember my face. And they say,
that's the one.
That bitch is going to kill me.
Yeah.
Not if I kill you but, first.
But when you're, yeah, when you walk into a Costco and you see them rotating on their skewers,
and
you
can't resist. And the smell. Again, why aroma. Is it, why are they $4.99?
How are they $4.99?
How are they How? $4.99?
When you think about the fact that a chicken's life is $4.99, that makes me ill. That makes me ill.
If you were to put on a skewer and roasted like a chicken, how much would you want to go for?
I would do that for free.
Yeah, I know.
That sounds free perfect.
Sample.
Yeah,
I'd be the free sample.
Yeah, that sounds great. Like, when was the last time you were skewered?
The last time I personally was skewered? Oh, I don't know. Months and months ago, I was skewered.
That sucks.
And I haven't been. I haven't been in pits. I haven't been in a pit. You know what I mean? When they're roasting them in a pit. I haven't been in a pit in a.
Bit
in a bit. I have been in the pit in the bit.
I remember always kind of having beef with like the other kids who were there with their moms at BJ's. Do you know what I mean?
Because it was kind of like playtime.
I was like, why the fuck are you here? I'm here because I should be here, but you're a kid.
Yeah, shouldn't like, you be at school?
Shouldn't you be at daycare? Like, I'm here as a professional. Like, I'm a homemaker.
Yeah.
Why are you also here playing with your Nintendo DS? Put the DS down and look around.
You're like, you're I'm here Mecca. To get a book, and you don't read.
Yeah.
That would be the vibe that you gave me, I feel like.
You think I was if just like you an did, absolute bitch.
Yeah, if you didn't know me and you saw me at Costco, you'd be
like... Oh, I would hate you. We would have severe beef.
Yeah.
I wish we met when we were in
because I would take your sample.
You've taken plenty of my samples before, let's be honest.
I would, if there was one sample left...
You would take that in a heartbeat.
I would take it in a heartbeat and claw it in my mouth.
Yep. Going there before a party, going there before any event, you're stocking up on the 3-for-1 family size bag of Lay's chips.
Oh, of course. Of course.
The candy section.
I almost sometimes I pass by some of these things at Costco, BJ's, whatever, and I'm like, too much. When can we learn our limits?
You don't need 200 baby bottle pops.
Nobody needs that. But when it's Halloween,
you go to Costco.
But I'm still not trying to spend $24.99 on 20 candy bars to give out to the little schmucks.
You're going to use the S word? It almost sounds like a slur.
Schmuck?
I remember one time I used the word schmuck and my mom was so mad at me.
Wait, she was
like,
really?
Don't say that. And I was like, there's literally a Steve Carell movie about this. Schmuck.
Wait, schmuck?
Schmuck. It could be a slur.
It could be a slur. Or my mom is just insane.
Both also could be
true. Well, my mom hated when I said stupid.
Oh, I couldn't use the S word. Shut up.
Shut up.
If I told my sister to shut up, it'd be like I said literally like, fuck you, you fucking bitch.
Yeah. Can you imagine? Shut up to your mom's face.
Oh, I've never in my entire, I can't even imagine.
I would be taken down.
Yes. Like. Were you going to say like.
Yeah, unfortunately. And then I decided not
to. Were you going to make a 9/11 reference?
Joe.
No. Yes.
Maybe.
Did you ever get yelled at in a Costco by your parents, by your mom?
Yeah.
Getting in trouble in a supermarket is one of the most humiliating things a person could have happen to them.
It's worse than when your mom says to you, like, don't make me embarrass you in front of your cousins. Don't make me smack you in front of your cousins.
I can only assume that Carol has said that to you about 400 times. Because every time you say it, I'm like, I'm there in the room. Don't make me embarrass you in front of your cousins. Is the best threat.
Because it really is, especially in a supermarket. It's like, where do you escape to?
You can't.
You know that you're entering with your parents and you're exiting. So even if there's tension that is arising.
And there always is.
Because Costco, BJ's, Sam's Club is a pleasurable experience for until the child it's until it's not. But for the parent, it's you're stressed.
Yeah.
You're like, how much do I need? How much meat do I need?
Yes.
If there's a party, what do I get?
Yes.
What's happening?
I gotta get the 64 ounce of Folgers coffee because there's no other option.
Of course.
Like, and then you have a kid who's either begging for some dumb shit that they don't need, some plastic garbage toy, or is being a little bitch.
Yeah.
Well, or is just following. My mom used to always be like, why are you right on top of me? Go somewhere else. Yeah. Get away from me. And I couldn't.
Again, they want, they have their own process. And when you can, when you infiltrate, it freaks them out.
I used to bring like my Game Boy sometimes.
Yeah.
And like play it while walking around.
You were walking and playing?
Walking and playing.
That kind of Joe takes like a lot of skill and also
hand-eye coordination. And it's shocking because I have BVD.
Katie, you don't even know what you have.
Binocular vision dysfunction.
Yeah. Yeah, you're seeing double. You're seeing double of those samples in Costco. Does Costco, first of all, I will say if I've noticed anything, and this is coming from conversation from your mother as well. She infiltrated. She let us
know.
She
did. She did talk about
it. Costco doesn't have that many options. BJ's has the most options, but what Costco does have.
No, Sam's Club has the most
options. Sam's Club has the most options. BJ's middle of the pack has good
prices.
Prices.
No, BJ's is more expensive.
Let me start this over. Costco doesn't have many options.
No.
They have, it's kind of like get what you get and you don't get upset.
It's kind of like Trader Joe's.
They also, the Kirkland brand itself, does Costco have a factory or are they Trader Joe's-ing it by taking other products and slapping Kirkland on it? If I was to run a business like Costco, I would as well.
Well, I saw a TikTok recently where someone was like, how come like this Walmart brand cream cheese tastes this way, but this one that has a light blue on it that has no other differentiation tastes completely different? And then this person was explaining it and they were like, because wholesalers will buy another company's, because like say like, so Costco wants to sell Swedish meatballs, but they don't want to produce the Swedish meatballs, so they want to sell them under their name. So they will buy it from other companies wholesale, slap their label on it, push it out. So yeah, like I think in most of these situations, but they could buy two. So here's the crazy part. Here's where it gets crazy. That's
cheating.
It's cheating.
And I hate the cheater saying it's cheating,
because you could get two different versions. Like two different companies might produce the Swedish meatballs for Costco. So you could have the same label, and the meatballs could be completely different. And it doesn't. And it's legal. And it's fine.
Listen, I don't want to be the cops, but
yes, you do.
I would love nothing more.
Hello?
I'm kidding, guys. That was satire. I don't want to be the cops, but in this situation, someone's got to bust through that door and fix it.
And it should be you.
And it should be. This is
why you should get involved in local government.
Joe, you keep pushing local politics on me. It's like, this is like a cycle of violence at this
point. Yeah, it is. I'm perpetuating.
You're perpetuating. Like, I don't want to run for office. Yet. But, like, if I was to run for office in, like, 10, 15 years.
And I write the speeches.
Would you write my speeches? And, yeah.
Am I your campaign manager this time?
Yeah, absolutely, Joe. I couldn't imagine anybody else.
Oh, you couldn't imagine that random girl from fourth grade?
That was fourth grade, Joe. Like, what do you want me to say? I was trying to be nice to somebody. I was trying to be nice.
Why didn't you try to be nice to me?
Because I was already nice to you.
Were you?
Yeah, I was already nice to you. Were you nice to me?
Yeah. Yeah.
Yeah?
Yeah, I would have ran the shit out of your campaign. I was loyal.
Honestly would have, like, the way that you would have, like,
your website would have been amazing. Did you have a website?
No.
Did you have merch?
No.
Who won? Minhall did. It's not about winning. It's about maximizing the sleigh. It's about maximizing the opportunity for
branding. But the thing is, maybe I just wanted to go to simple in nature. I wanted to be, I didn't want to like pull out all the stops. I was using myself. I was running. The website wasn't running and neither was the merch. I was running. Only the real ones were getting jeans at Costco. Only the real ones did that. They might have bled on any surface that you sat on, but $9, stretchy, perfect wash.
$9 for a pair of jeans.
You can't beat that. You can't beat that because I was getting jeans and I was getting about 150 Welch's fruit snack.
I want you to guess what BJ stands for. I want you to guess what BJ's stands for.
Okay, I got this. It's so easy. I think that the B stands for budget, And the J stands for budget justified.
Beverly Jean. The name of my firstborn daughter is Beverly Jean BJ's.
Beverly Jean. Wait, I'm sorry. Why are they calling it BJ's?
When they should be calling it Beverly Jeans.
Wait,
why aren't the jeans called the Beverly Jeans? Why aren't the jeans being sold at BJ's called Beverly Jeans? Beverly Jeans. The daughter of the first president of BJ's, Beverly Jean.
How much chicer would it be? Like, you're not calling Ralph Lauren RL. RLs.
No.
You're calling it Ralph Lauren.
Right.
Everyone should be saying, Beverly. Oh, get in the car. We're going to Beverly Jeans.
It sounds like a Southern clothing brand now.
It's beautiful.
Beverly Jeans. There was always an anxiety leaving a Costco where, like, they were checking your receipt, where I was like, did my mom shoplift? Yeah. And are we going to go to jail right now?
Because some people took it more seriously than others. Yes. Sometimes they just strip it with the highlighter or the Sharpie, whatever they were given that day. Some of them will look down at the receipt, look at the cart, look back down at the receipt.
Start counting.
You're all set.
And you're am I all set?
I know.
Are you guys going to follow me into the parking
Costco
lot?
Really is a cult. They said, get that cart or you can't be here.
Yeah.
Get that cart or you can't be here. And you want a bag? Go fuck yourself. How about you take the damn Mott's applesauce box that we got when we unpacked it for you to put your produce in?
Yeah, for you to put your pork roast in.
How about that? You get the
box. I would do anything to live in a Costco.
Anything.
I loved the books. I loved how they displayed their books all flat on one table.
Of course.
Like it was a Scholastic book fair. You know, like you had to crane your neck to see what books were in the center.
Yeah.
That was incredible. You would walk into the biggest TVs you've ever seen in your entire life. Almost new age technology.
Yes, always. Every time you walk into Costco, you're kind of like,
I've never seen anything like this before.
The screens have gotten flatter?
Then there was almost like a treehouse, right?
A treehouse, maybe in the back section, kind of close to where you would see the refrigerator section and the bakery.
No,
is where they would have like.
I'm seeing play like toys. They'd have like, it wasn't a treehouse, but they would have like, oh, you can get your siding remodeled or like new.
Yes,
and they'd have like a sample of a home.
Yes,
in the beginning of Costco.
Yes, and sometimes there were attendants
who would solicit.
Yes,
and I hated that. That would stress them. They'd be like, "How are you today? I'm not. It has nothing to do with me.
Get away from me." It's kind of like exactly like it's the mall. It's the mall when they're trying to sell you the fucking face cream.
Like, miss, have you ever curled your hair before?
I'm like, yeah.
Good children to the cafeteria.
Okay. So last night, I was a little bit zooted. And I was walking around the supermarket. And I saw these little wafer bars. I've never had them before. I brought them home thinking Joe was going to be ecstatic. He's never had. Of course he's had. Today we're having Skippy creamy wafer bars topped with chocolate. And then, listen, I got the Coca-Cola Haribo. I'm going to go Haribo.
I remember having... Remember the squeeze? The Skippy, it's the Skippy, it's the squeeze.
Creamalicious peanut butter that you eat like no other.
Squeeze, the Skippy, it's the Skippy, it's the squeeze.
And it comes from the people
No, but I do think that there needs to be a verse of... Someone needs to buy the rights to that song.
It was like literally just a tube. It was a tube of peanut butter. It was like a Go-Gurt, if you will. It was like a Go-Gurt tube, but for peanut butter...
And you just like squeeze
it into your
but
mouth.
I guess that makes sense because you're either squeezing in mouth or squeezing and shimmying.
Yeah, like bringing it with you somewhere. But I remember in first grade, I brought in Skippy Squeeze and I was having it at snack time. And my teacher was like, is that just peanut butter? And I'll never forget the feeling of being judged for Skippy Squeeze.
She squeezed your Skippy.
She's Andrew.
I'm sorry. Like, it's just like,
ooh. I feel like they brought these back. Like, I feel like I had this as a child.
Maybe that's what it was. I'm kind of really excited. Oh, it's like a pretty thick layer of peanut butter. I mean, it's pretty phenomenal if you ask me. But
it's missing something.
It might be missing something. Almost as it's not that sweet.
It's not that sweet.
But I'm gonna tell you something. Is there a film collecting at the back of your throat already?
Always, always.
You know what? I'm gonna say it. This reminds me of like a protein bar dupe.
Yes.
I don't want to be eating a Power Crunch protein bar when I'm having a Skippy wafer. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
Yeah, no, that's not, it's not necessarily my favorite snack I've ever had, but it's good to know because my eyes have been lingering on that box for weeks. I'm just going to have a few gummies, even though it does not go with what the snack was today.
I'm not going to have a single gummy, I can tell you that.
But you did introduce me to these gummies.
You're kidding.
No, I swear to you. What? I'll never forget, like, I feel like you were frequenting cola gummies. Frequenting.
You never were having them?
No.
You're kidding.
You would have them at your house. I would eat.
I didn't know that. Remember Dylan's Candy Bar? Were you a stealer? Did you steal from Dylan's Candy Bar?
Well, I think it's when it introduced stealing to me, but they had a lingerer. Somebody's job was lingerer.
It was scary in Dylan's Candy Bar. Yeah, that was like a prison state.
Can you imagine?
Being Dylan?
Well, I wish, I mean, can you imagine being Dylan?
Dylan's like, who's Dylan's dad?
Ralph.
Ralph Lauren.
Yeah. No, the lingerer in Dylan's Candy Bar was out to get everyone.
That was literally, it was legitimately like the police read a station in every Dylan's Candy Bar. But did you ever steal from a Dylan's Candy Bar? What were you taking?
Of course, like a gummy. When you're, this is the thing, it's not stealing as much as it is
sampling.
You put a few gummies in your bag. You take one gummy for yourself. I already put the gummy in the bag. You know what I mean? I'm already getting the gummies.
No, I can't get behind that. I really can't. Unfortunately, I am a stickler for rules through and through.
I do believe that if you're going to be saying that you can scoop and serve your own, you can pick and please your own candy, I need to know. If I see something that I've never had before, before I pay for it, I should know what it tastes like.
Do you get to sample a cheeseburger before you eat it? Do you get to sample?
No, because I know what a cheeseburger is.
No, you don't. You know what can't, you know what sugar.
I know the foundations.
You know the foundation of a gummy.
Think about an ice cream shop.
That's, well, I hate people who get samples at ice cream shops. Of course. I always have. I think it's insane. Pick your flavor, deal with it. You get what you get and you don't get upset.
You want to try.
You get what you get you and walk you don't
into,
get upset.
Because you walk into an ice cream shop and I see 30 flavors. I'm like,
you have about 40 plastic spoons in your hand by the end of it because I'm, you're like, trying every single one.
Oh my gosh. Lavender, vanilla. I need to try that. What if it's too much lavender? What if I taste it and I'm like, oh, that's not the one.
That's too bad. You ordered
it. I got two scoops.
It's like the destruction of culture for free samples.
Here
at places.
He goes it's with insane. The destruction of culture.
It's insane to me that you want to say I deserve to try six different ice cream flavors before I net on the
I'm
one I want.
I'm not gonna try six.
I've
different
seen you
flavors
try a lot of ice cream flavors.
Normally they limit you to two.
Because you've probably pushed that limit many times. You're the reason that limit exists.
Well,
people like you are the reason they had to.
Sometimes you gotta set limits because some people are limitless.
Good children to the guidance office.
Good children. Hi. So this is Ellie and Maddie here. We are just tuning in. We're calling.
Tune in every week
since day one,
and we just can't stop thinking about you guys. Can't stop thinking about how badly we just feel like we're best friends.
And speaking of best friends, we have a question. So we've been really contemplating, like, now that we're post-grad in the working world, it's really hard, you know, seeing each other all the time and having that one-on-one bestie time. And we just want to know your guys' advice on
staying with your bestie and being an adult and how you can deal with finding time and quality time with each other.
We love you guys so
we
much.
Love you.
Think about you every day. Bye.
No, I love that you think about us every day. That's so sweet. Listen, I think how we found bestie time is
living together,
which for some people, I know,
might be a lot.
Might be a lot. I think that we live well together. I really think we that, do. Like, yeah, there could be things that annoy each other, but at the end of the day, like, we go to bed and we're like,
excellently together.
Yeah, I like, do think. Truly.
I think it's because we kind of lived together our whole lives. Like, yeah. We know how to co-inhabit a space. Yeah. Like, I know your tendencies. You know my tendencies. Yeah. I think the timeline you put on your friendships is, like, what causes them to end. Like, if you're like, oh, like, we're college friends, so now we're going to leave college and, like, find new friends and move on. Like, well, if you think that way, of course. But, like, if you see your friendships as more of, like, a long-term lasting thing, like, it's not that I would factor in you for every decision for the rest of my life, but, like, in the current moment, I'm like, well, I'm going to factor in, like, how Andrew fits into things, obviously. I feel like it's vice versa. Yeah, like,
for sure.
And that, I think, creates, a longer-term friendship. It's, like,
if you were to move to Australia, I'm moving to Australia. Well,
you would do that in a heartbeat.
Yeah.
Yeah, of course. And it's, like, those kind of... It's like, it's really like seeing your friends as family. Yes. Like, that's the kind of level. It's like, I would factor my family into decisions in the same way I'd factor you into decisions. Yeah. Like, I think as long as you continue to prioritize that friendship, and sure, it'll ebb and flow. Like, you'll date, you'll get a really big job, it'll take up a lot of your time. You'll, like, be able to spend less time with each other. But if you still prioritize seeing that person and actually talking to them, I feel like you're fine.
Yeah. And I mean, like, if they're your best friend, like, clearly you have similarities, you're listening to Good Children, you're watching Heartstopper, you have things to talk about, you have things to, like, discuss. I think for us, like, we are a little bit different. Well, maybe not, but, like, we, even growing up, I would hang out with you every day.
Right.
Like, even if I wasn't hanging out with you every day, I would hang out with you 4 out of the 7 days.
Right.
Like,
yeah.
So it was just normal that we would hang out that much.
Yeah.
And I think we both grew up with that and weren't in relationships and whatever, so, like, we already were factored in that
right
way. But yeah, it's like, if you want to set an amount of time that you want to spend two days a week, like, do it that way. But yeah, write them in as family. I agree.
I think keep
go to Costco.
Go
once
to
a
Costco
week. Once a week with your best friend.
I gotta get to Costco.
We need a card.
And I guess we'll see you next week for a brand new episode. Thank you so much for tuning in. And don't forget to do your homework.
Like, comment, subscribe, rate, review, write a little something sweet, please. 5 stars. 5 stars. We said at the beginning of the episode, Patreon, $7. And you know where to find us. We're across all social media platforms at Good Children Pod. I'm on Instagram at Andrew Muscarella, on TikTok at Andrew_Muskie.
I'm on Instagram at Joe Hegyes, and on TikTok at Be Quiet Joe. And it's time to go to Costco.
It's time to go to Costco. I need a damn hot dog.
This is me swallowing my pride, standing in front of you, saying I'm sorry for that night. And I go back to December all the time. It turns out freedom ain't nothing but missing. I don't want to do it.